All right, today we're going to talk about how to use the citation feature within EBSCO. So I've done a search here in our EBSCO Discovery service and found a whole list of articles in here. And if you bring up these articles, whether it comes from within EBSCO or from another database, you can go to this view here with the abstract. Now, right over here, there you'll notice this little button that says cite. What you can do there, click cite. Then it'll bring up a list of citation styles for this article. Here's an APA citation right here. So what we could do is just highlight over that, copy that, and you could paste it into a Word document. And it'll look a little funny when it comes in. Notice that highlighting and all that behind there. What I usually do when I bring things in from EBSCO or from other databases is after I paste it, I click this little clipboard and click this blue arrow so it removes any extra formatting that was added. So this is pretty good. There's a few things you'll notice that are wrong about it. Certainly that second line should be indented over. We should have a hanging indent. Let me make this a little bit bigger so we can see this a little bit easier. So one of the first thing I would notice there is we would need to do that. And how you would do that, there's a quick way to do that. Go to paragraph right here in Word, and in different versions of Word, it'll be in different places. But in the version I'm using, there's a little arrow right here that's a shortcut to the paragraph settings. And with the indentation, we could set that to a hanging indent. Make sure it's set to double for your line spacing. And I generally leave this on. If it's not on, I would turn it on. Don't add space between paragraphs of the same style. Okay, when we do that, it reformats it correctly. And it does look like they did a good job with the citation. You'll always want to double check these to make sure that they're correct. And what you would do if you wanted to double check those, from the library website, just beneath the searching guides and things, if you go down here to APA resources and click there, it'll take you to the Writing Center, and you could go to reference examples. And you could compare the citations that come up to these citation examples that they've given you here. So it's a pretty good process there. Let's close this. Let's go back to the result list. And when this goes there, I'm just going to grab another one of these. Let's just go into this one here. And then again, right over here, cite. And then there's an APA citation right there. So I'm just going to hover over it, highlight it, copy it. Go into my Word document, and I'm going to paste this in. And again, it came in with some of the strange formatting, like the background, so I'm going to take that off with the blue arrow here. Takes it back to a more normal looking thing here. And then just going to look over it. Now this one, you notice there's a problem. In APA, only the first, they use sentence case, so only the first word of this title should be capitalized, unless there's any other proper nouns, but there aren't. So what we're going to do, we're going to uncapitalize these. Now we could go in and just delete everyone. There's a quick little trick I'm going to show you here. I'm going to highlight here. I'm going to hold down my control key, and I'm going to highlight everything that should not be capitalized. We're going to leave that acronym capitalized there, but I'm holding down my control key. I'm highlighting everything here that should not be capitalized. None of these words need to be capitalized. So I'm just going to highlight all of these with my control key. And there was a whole lot of them. So that would have been a lot of deleting and retyping. So I'm going to go here. Now on my keyboard, I'm going to hold down Shift, my Shift key, and then the function key up the top, F3. Shift, F3. Okay, did you notice that? Now all of those letters are lowercase. We could go the other way too if we needed to. Shift, F3. Just like that. So that fixed the capitalization. Let me look at the rest of this. The rest of it looks good. For the journal title, all of the words, all the important words should be capitalized. So it's a little different. Anyways, it looks pretty good here. And so that's an introduction of how to use the citation generator within EBSCO. It works pretty well. You will have to do a little editing with it. And that's what I always pull it into Word and do my editing there. So please let me know if you have any questions on this or any other library-related or information-related questions, and I'll do my best to help you. Thanks a lot.